Yo, I got a shout out Dosa Dion, man, because it was actually the first time I went live on YouTube. And, you know, guys don't know Dosa Dion. He put out a lot of good content for the Detroit Lions.
What is up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are going to be taking a look at the Detroit Lions defense against the Chicago Bears. Some of the noticeable changes that just popped out to me with and without Matt Patricia. Also, the adjustments or the halftime adjustments that the Detroit Lions made, which made a huge difference. I mean, it really did change the game because the first half, well, let's just say it was not very good, okay? We understand that the first half was awful. The Detroit Lions gave up 23 points. They gave up over 100 yards rushing. It was a terrible performance in the first half. It was like, okay, wow, this defense looks way worse than they with Patricia, and that's a problem, right? That's a big problem. However, the second half, we saw adjustments. We saw a defense that instead of getting worse as the game went on, they got much better in the second half. And I wanted to touch on some of the major changes, the tweaks that they made during the game, but also just a couple of things that popped out to me on the field of certain players playing, who played where, that kind of thing. This first clip is pretty simple. I'm just showing you a clip of the first half. This basically sums up the Lions' pass defense in the first half. Lions, maybe they show some pressure, they stack the box, they have one safety deep to help against the run, and they get with the play action, every linebacker's pushed up against the line, and you get a completion. That was basically, in one play, our first half against this Bears defense. And Mitchell Trubisky was just lighting us up. I mean, it was like, wow, here we go again. Here we go again with Trubisky lighting us up. However, this is the biggest change, the most notable change in the second half. And it didn't always work. But I have to give Coyle a lot of credit for going for it, okay? Because something had to change. You couldn't just keep doing the same thing. It wasn't working. And the only thing I could think of was, hey, you got to get after this guy. You're going to have to. You're going to have to bring pressure something. I think he pulled a little bit of a note out of his Jim Schwartz book, you know, back from his time in Philly, and said, yeah, let's bring some pressure. Let's bring some blitzes. And look, blitzes don't always equal success, and we'll watch that. But this was, to me, the biggest difference between the first half and second half. I counted at least like six of these, and there was probably much more than that. I didn't count nearly as many in the first half. The Lions were getting after. You can see here, they're showing, but they're coming. They're bringing about, what was that, five? Five is a blitz, by the way, guys. They bring five, they drop Jamie, and all of a sudden you get guys like Justin Coleman who go up and make the tackle because you force the ball out of his hand. You know, we've seen before that even if he just senses pressure, he'll just get the ball out of his hands, okay? Even if it's not really there. Like in this situation right here, right? The Lions are bringing a five-man rush. Now, there is pressure off the edge, but he's going to get it up. He's going to get that ball out of his hands very quickly if he senses pressure. So then you have these big cornerbacks who we've drafted that can go up and tackle. We signed them, we drafted them to do that, and we go up and make the tackle. That was the biggest difference to me from the first half and the second half. And something had to happen. Didn't always work. We'll see an example here of how it didn't necessarily work. Because look, when you blitz, you're going to leave holes. So if you can't get there and the quarterback sees where the blitz came from and you don't cover up that hole right away, they're going to have a completion pretty easily. And that's what happened here. So credit to Trubisky. You can see what we do is we bring J-Ron Kearse here off the edge. Kearse played a pretty big role for us. We brought Kearse off the edge here. Didn't mean to do that. And, you know, that's a pretty heavy blitz. How many guys we got there? We got 1, 2, 3, 4. We got six guys on this blitz. Six guys. So we only have, quick math, five in coverage against four receivers. Lions are trying to get there, and he's able to get in underneath and complete the pass. But again, that was something he did different. It was an adjustment. It was trying something different, and I loved it because, well, obviously it worked, but two, it was something, it was trying something. We didn't just stay in the same thing and hope that all of a sudden worked. Now, this is one thing that I noticed about the personnel. Not saying we didn't do this with Patricia, but it was just something that I really noticed. Jelani Tafai played a lot of snaps for the Detroit Lions. I have right here 48% of the snaps. He played pretty much all the snaps from what I could tell in the inside. He's not a very fast linebacker. He's actually a pretty slow linebacker, but we knew that when we drafted him. So when you put him on the edge, he's usually just too slow for that. So Tavai in the inside, it worked really well. You also have Jamie in here. As usual, he played all but like two snaps. You put Romeo on the edge. He's got some athleticism. Same thing with Christian. But I mean, just like you got really five guys basically across this defensive line. And you really sold out to stop the run. Now, it wasn't like the Lions weren't doing this in the first half, but they weren't playing as aggressive. I think the run defense was a mixture of you're putting the guys out there to make the plays. We were missing some guys with injuries like Danny Shelton, things like that. So you asked other guys to step up. Nick Williams did big time. Pennacini did. Kevin Strong did. Those guys stepped up. So you had the game plan that, okay, we're going to have to put some major pieces, some big pieces in the box, right? They put some big guys in the box. I think it was a mixture between really them just, like the players said, getting their feet wet and getting it going, right? Because there was a lot of opportunities to make plays where it would break into a big run because they would simply just miss him or they wouldn't shed a block. I mean, there's not much you can really do to a certain extent. But they also played very aggressive in the second half. They played like their hair was on fire and they were just getting after it. And once they started to slow down the run game, the game changed because they were able to stop that, made it more one-dimensional, and they were relying more on Mitchell Trubisky to win the game for him, and you can't really do that. So when the run game was going, we were looking awful. But once we started to slow that down, we started to get things going again. And that's been kind of the story of our season. You know, we've gotten better at stopping the run. First half looked awful, but second half, we get bounced back. And I just want to show you guys here just how they lined everything up. You know, you got the three big bodies. Now, there is a downside to this. There's obviously a huge downside to this. You got a lot of size here, right? You got a lot of size in this front seven. The biggest downside, however, though, is that you're lacking speed. You're lacking speed. So when running backs like Cordell Patterson, they get to the outside, you lack that speed. When you hit them with a play action boot, you lack the speed. And we'll see where that hurt the Lions, but also how they can, I would say, attack that. Because no matter who we play this year, I mean, look at our remaining schedule. It really doesn't usually matter who you play, because if you can't stop the run, you're going to lose. Teams will just run all over you. But I mean, if you look at our schedule, we got a team coming up in Green Bay who has Aaron Jones. They have, I can't even think of the guy behind him, the big running back. I can't even think of the dude's name right now, the bowling ball. A.J. Dillon, they have really good running backs back there, and they will run the ball on you. And if you can't stop the run, you're going to have no shot of slowing down that offense. That offense is lethal even, you know, when the run game's struggling. But if you can't stop the run, you're not going to do anything, right? You're not going to have a chance against the Green Bay Packers. That's where it's got to start. Same thing, of course, Tennessee. Obviously, if you can't slow down Derrick Henry, you're in trouble, because Tannehill will dot you up. It sets up everything when you can run the ball very successfully. So, you know, I think it was a mix between the players getting a feet wet, just getting going, and you'll see here that this time the size pays off. The Lions just shut it down. And when they were able to keep Cordell Patterson inside, I think this is something Spielman also brought up. When they were able to keep Cordell Patterson inside between the tackles, they had success. When he broke that, that was when we were in trouble. That's when we were in trouble. Plus, once he got past that first layer, we were also in trouble because he's got a lot of speed. So look, you can see that time we're able to get to the outside. He's forced back inside, and you shut it down, because that's where all your meat is. That's where your big bodies are, right? That's where the 350-pound guys are. That's where your size is. That's where you want to get those running backs going. And here's just another example of the same thing here. Just a lot of size. You got Nick Williams here. You got Pennicini. I think that's Kevin Strong. You have Romeo Okor on the outside. Jamie, Tavai. And then you have someone coming off the edge here. I think that's Christian Jones that comes in off the edge. I think you'll see him. Yeah, there he is. So you just got a lot of size. And again, what we did here is you can see Romeo Okor getting the edge, setting the edge. And then you have Christian Jones, who dives down here. He helps set this edge, so it doesn't allow Montgomery to break it, because he's looking to do that. He's like, oh, I got to come back inside. And that's where you have your size. So that's really what it's all about. You don't have a lot of speed, so if they get the outside, you're in big trouble. But for the run defense, it was just about containing, keeping it in between the tackles, and the run defense, you know, it got much better. This time, he does get to the outside, but I think what putting all these big bodies on the defensive line actually do, you got Frank Heron in there this time, you got these four defensive linemen. Also, Everson Griffin's got a lot of athletic ability. Shout out to Everson, man. He gives crazy effort. Every time I watch this guy, I'm impressed. But you get guys like these linebackers now, Jamie Collins, who could play like the running back, right? You can just fill these lanes, fill the holes. You have Tracy Walker and Justin Coleman in here to take away these two options if it was a play action. Those guys need to be super disciplined. We'll take a look at an example later. But if those guys aren't disciplined, we get in trouble, because again, we don't have a lot of speed out there. But because of all these defense line, because you have the big bodies, it allows these linebackers to shoot gaps like running backs. And Jamie Collins, he's been doing this for a minute. And you can see Jamie just explodes it. He makes some big plays. Collins is a heck of a linebacker. And when he gets rolling, he's tough. He's tough to stop, okay? That's why you pay that guys like that a lot of money. You can see again here, showing blitz. It didn't always work, but we did it. We did something different. And it got Mr. Trubisky a little flustered. And I think we saw that, because then when we were not blitzing, we were able to get to him at times. Here you're going to show, and you bring it. You know, you got Everson coming off the edge. You know what? They get the little out route, but look at this hit. Boom! Just light him up. And you just shut the play down. It's a second and long. But notice, it's second and long. This one may have been a holding one. But that's the thing. When you get him in the second long, it really helped us with the blitz. So we had to stop the run first. Once the defense got his feet wet, got rolling, stopped the run, this blitz, we started to dial that up. Then it was just about, okay, if he gets it, if it's completed, go up and make that tackle. We'll play third and short, and, you know, we'll protect the sticks. Again, look how many rushers. This is six rushers. You're bringing a cornerback blitz off the edge, which makes it difficult to see. He does complete it, but again, it's second and long. Another situation like that, because your first down play, you were able to slow it down. You pick him up, it comes a third down. You may be watching this and thinking, okay, well, why are they giving up, you know, 7-8 yards just because they're blitzing on second down? Why don't they just drop into coverage? Well, because that was the first half. The Lions, in that situation, would just drop back, and when Trubisky had all day, he was just dotting up our zone. I mean, you have to think, our zone coverage has been pretty bad so far this season, even when we've been healthy. You know, you got a guy, Jeffrey Okuda, who really didn't do it in college, and this is his first year here, right? Their coverage has not been very good in zone. Plus, you're not even healthy. You're missing your veteran, a true fun. You're missing that Jeffrey Okuda. So you're relying on these backup cornerbacks. So for the Lions, they had to get after him. They couldn't leave these guys on islands. They couldn't leave them in a zone where they had to fill their zones because they weren't feeling that responsibility well enough. So they had to do something different. And it was get after the quarterback. At least get the ball out of his hands and play to your strengths. Because the one strength that we've seen out of every cornerback this year is the ability to tackle. Coverage has been shaky. But tackling, that's one thing we've been able to rely on from the secondary unit. So we played to that strength in the second half. That's why, Onlin, to me, I got to give him some credit for that. Another example of bringing just too many guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have 6 coming. I think Collins may actually drop here. But, you know, the offensive linemen, they have to respect that. They have to respect that that's going to happen. So then, yep, he drops over the middle, take that initial look away. Great blitz design. 5 is a blitz. You bring him off the edge, he's going to be unblocked because he's going to take the inside guy first. And because of that, the pass just a little bit too up for outside, and it's incomplete. Now it's a 3rd down and got us off the field. That was the major thing. When it comes to adjustments, it was simple, man. They were bringing heat. Onlin didn't sit back anymore. He's like, you know what? I'm going to get after him. We got to make him uncomfortable because what we're doing is not working. Here you're going to see Reggie Ragland. We actually saw less Reggie Ragland than I think usual. Ragland only 35% of the snaps, if I'm right on that. That's less than Tavai. But when Tavai's tired, we're able to rotate a guy like this in. And this is kind of just what Jamie Collins did as well. Just explode the hole. And by the way, for anybody, you know, talking about Jelani Tavai, look, we've said Jelani Tavai is struggling this year. He was the 2nd highest graded defensive player on the Lions. 2nd highest graded defensive player this week on the Lions. So putting him in the inside, you can tell he's in his own element. And again, we're getting back to, I guess what you could say is where he's comfortable. Here you're going to see a nice little cross blitz, people looking for the stunts. Well, there you get one. Now, the issue with this is, again, you're bringing speed to get to the quarterback. So what you're doing here is, now that you're doing this cross, this is the blitz because it's 5. So you're dropping your ends into cover. Just a different way to mix it up. And I like it. Right? I like that, just mixing it up, doing something different. That way they don't know where the blitz is coming from, because they do it, so you're in trouble. So this time they bring the safety Walker for speed. He's not able to get there in time, unfortunately. So what you're lacking now on the outside, because you bring the speed, is you're lacking the speed. And so you can see, since he was just able to get off, you have Everson one-on-one. I think this was Mooney one-on-one underneath. Now, huge credit to Everson Griffin here. I mean, this is awesome effort. He almost catches him. That's awesome effort, just running so hard, he slides down. That's good effort. Not able to get there. But that was the thing. Didn't always work. And it's not always going to work. Blitzing does not equal good. Blitzing is just something that you have to do sometimes to just change the game up. And it was something that we had to do, because in the first half, we nearly did not do enough of that. And here's another example. So I talked about the weakness is speed. The weakness is going to be speed. Well, here's a great example of your weakness being speed. But this can be avoided. The thing is, yes, your weakness is speed, because you're putting out, you know, all these big bodies. But this can be avoided if you stay home. Look at Tracy Walker. Look at Daron Harmon. Look at these guys being disciplined. Unfortunately, Will Harris here, because of the motion, he's trying to get back a spot. So he bites on the run. He bites on the run. And look at this. He's just way too late to recover. If he stays with his guy, if he doesn't bite on this run, if he stays home, which he should, if he does that, there's nothing here because everything else is covered. But he's late and it turns into a touchdown. So really what was there, everything can be fixed. And I just like the fact that we saw adjustments and his defense started to get it going. And the biggest, I think, and here's another one with the speed, Cordell Patterson. You'll see another example here. This is just simply just not getting off the block. You know, you got to get that. You got to get that edge. Maybe, you know, holding, but, you know, you just got to get off there. Oh, we got to make the play. That's just speed. And that's what teams are going to attack us with if we're going to play these kind of fronts. So, you know, you got to be prepared for that. But this is where I think the biggest difference was. This is the 3rd down play. You didn't bring a blitz. But because you kept showing it and showing it and showing it, they have to respect it. So you got Trubisky, you know, maybe a little bit flustered there, maybe a little bit worried about the blitz. So he's waiting, but now you're not blitzing. Now you're dropping into the flat. You take away the underneath route. It was just a perfect play calling for the time being. Nothing there, and you get the strip sack. And that's just, you know, defense line. That's just what happens. We have Romeo and Everson, and we're going to get Trey Flowers back. That's talent. That's just talent winning one-on-ones. And that's what you got to get sometimes. You just need to win one-on-ones. I think, you know, they needed that because we weren't winning one-on-ones in the first half. You know, you see, okay, you notice how all of a sudden we win one-on-one because there's life there. There's energy there. Well, you didn't get that in the first half. These one-on-ones were happening. So we were forced to say, okay, second half, we're going to have to start dialing up pressure because we're not getting it with our front four. So you started dialing it up. Energy, life, this team's motivated. This was the first time this year this defense, in my opinion, stepped up every single time we needed it. Every time we needed it in the second half, they made the play. Every time. Turnover, you know, you had to get off the field. You got to get us the ball back. Every time we needed it, they stepped up. And it's because the front four wasn't winning early, but when you started to dial some pressure, you started to get some things going. You started to get some hits on the quarterback. Okay, I feel good here. So now when you mix it up a little bit, offensive line doesn't know what to expect. Defensive line's feeling good. You're getting some pressure. You're dropping the coverage. Defense is great. So shout out to Corey Lynn for the adjustments. Shout out to the defense for, you know, getting their feet wet, getting this thing rolling. This is the first game without Matt Patricia. So it was all on Corey Unland here to do the defense. We have an offensive-minded coach, all on Corey Unland. And you know what? He made the adjustments. He tried something different, and it worked. But, man, I loved it. If you guys want me to take a look at the offense, I can't. Let me know your thoughts, comments below. Thank you, Pride, for watching. And I'm out. Are you kidding me right now? I had to put my helmet on for this one. Are you kidding? Look at this. Look at all these members. What? Yo, hey, shout out to all the members, man. Look how many All-Pro members there are. Like, literally, it's the whole screen, dog. This is crazy. The patrons, of course, the Hall of Fame members, man. Y'all got the gold color. It's kind of yellow, but it's supposed to be gold. Shout out to all the members, man. If you want to be a part of this, all you got to do is join the channel. But there are perks that come with it. Stay locked in the community tab if you are a member, because that's where a lot of information comes out. I appreciate all of you. What?